This is John Cavalli, and this is our Q4, yes, Q4, quarterly newsletter, audio, video, podcast-ish review. And I do this in this type of format so that if you can listen, you may be driving down the street. If you're driving down the street and listen only mode, keep your hands on the wheel. I always say that, but I always get a kick out of it. And I go into a little bit more of details on the thinking of it rather than just the newsletter. So those of you that receive the paper newsletter, it's in the mail, headed your way right now. And I want to go to this first main article. I ran a blog post on it that was in a very shortened version. And it's a survey. It's actually two surveys. For those of you that are in listen-only mode, I am in the at the main article on the first page, and it's by Natexis. Thankfully, I got the approval to do this. I had phone calls to a very nice, delightful lady in New York that was the PR person. She said, sure, and she even said, as I was saying what I was doing, she's like, can you believe the results? So let's go to the results. Those of you in listen-only mode, I am pulling on down to page two because the main article bleeds into almost the whole newsletter. It dominated the newsletter. Here's the key. There's two different folks that were surveyed. See if I can get this all on one page. I can't. The first are individuals. There were 8,550 individuals. Each one of them had at least $100,000 of investable assets invested. And then the second part of the survey were institutional folks, and there were 500 total institutional folks, ranging from corporate pension plans. You can see those that are in listen-only mode. I've basically got the cutout of what it was, and it's got pension plans. It's got a breakdown of everything. So, all right. So you've got 8,500 and some odd individuals, and then you've got professional institutional investors, and you start asking them what their expectations are, and it is amazing. Worldwide, their next 10 years expected return averaged 14.5% over inflation via the 8,500 individuals. Guess what the professionals, they were expecting 5 versus 15. It's 174% difference. That's globally. Now, as I was doing this, I found out that I could drill down in the survey and found out what the United States estimates were. So financial professionals in the United States expected a little over a 6%, 6.7% return, which is a little bit higher. We could maybe take issue with that. We've got somebody else that is going to take issue with that. But the individuals expect 17.5%. We can't say that's not going to happen. We can say it's a low probability of that. And this is 17.5% per year for the next 10 years. Or 14.5 by the global ones. Hope people aren't planning their retirement based on that. So I pull out a good friend of mine, not friend, a known person in the community, is Robert Arnott, and he recently released the ability to have his information put to basically printed. You can put it on Twitter, and before it was all copyright protected, and so his estimate gave a high and a low, and the high was 5.7, but the median was quite a bit lower. Now, this guy manages tens of billions of dollars, and he is, Donald and I first met him through the CFA program because he was one of the big muckety-mucks, super, super smart guy. I met him a few times, so he wouldn't go, hey, John, if we were driving down the street and see, so... I go into a little bit about the investment concerns, and more interestingly, parlayed on the investment concerns were the fact that basically in some countries, those of you that are just listening, some countries were not even worried about tax increases, and other the countries were kind of all over the place on their investment concerns. Okay, let's go back to really our only other article that was in this, and this came from a Chance podcast, and it's about Kyle Bass. And those of you that are listening, I am in the very first page, but I'm going to jump to the seventh page. Listen to a neat podcast with Mr. Bass. He's actually local big money man here in the state of Texas. And the most interesting thing that he was predicting, and actually it's at the time of the prediction, it was looked like a stretch, but he was predicting that oil hits $100 a barrel by the end of the year. At the time, it was in the 60s. Now we're up pushing 70, 75, and it's looking like he may be interesting. He may be correct. Another interesting thing that he said, and this is at the time, this was a month or two ago, he talked about the variant wasn't going to be as big of a deal as he thought. And then lastly, or as many people thought, and then lastly, he felt like the Federal Reserve was going to continue being very supportive. So very positive. All of his topics were positive, and I wanted to kind of put that in. And in all honesty, this first article kept, as I kept writing it, it got longer and longer, and I missed a bunch of economic stats that I wanted to do. So that's going to go in charts and graphs and kind of a collage. That's going to go into the next, the Q1 2022, which is just right around the corner. I'm back. For those of you that are in listen-only mode, I am back on the first page, and I am going to thank you for your time. So have a great day. Have a great start to fall, and I thank you for listening to this and look forward to the mail.